Hare Krishna. So we welcome you all for our Sunday Feast program. On behalf of Shri Radha Gopinath Mandir, I express my gratitude to all of you that you had option to go elsewhere and spend your Sunday afternoon somewhere else. You had a choice to see this online, hear this online, but still you took out your time, took effort, endeavor to come here and hear this katha about Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu and Lord Krishna. So in this world, we see people are doing business. And everyone likes business for one reason. What is that? Profit. One thing we take endeavor, we take all efforts that somehow or other I should earn profit. That is the only one thought behind any endeavor, any enterprises we take into. And Krishna consciousness, Prabhupada says in Nectar of Instruction, Upadeshamrit, he coins such a wonderful phrase, you are awestruck with such phrases. He said, Krishna consciousness, our temples are like hospitals. I never heard such explanation. We had understanding about temple means what? Just go, ring a bell, bow your head, ask something and go out. Staying more than 5 minutes in a temple is considered something strange. But Prabhupada said, this is hospital and we have to get cured. And this interesting phrase which I was talking about, which Prabhupada coined in Nectar of Instruction, he said that Krishna consciousness is like chambers of commerce. We all have seen here in Mumbai, there is a union, a chamber of commerce, a people who do business. They come together and they discuss how to earn profit, where to invest our money. That is the chamber of commerce. And here also, Prabhupada is saying this is the business. Krishna consciousness is a business. It is a chamber of commerce. And what profit we are supposed to be earning? A very beautiful phrase was spoken by Tukaram Maharaj, a saint in Maharashtra, that he says that Tuka mane labh hoya to vyapar kara. Tuka mane labh hoya to vyapar kara. Tyala kaya far shikavave. One thing we have never learnt in our life, but we have carried with us, that is how to earn profit. Tyala kaya far shikavave. When somebody is doing business, he doesn't go for a business to get or to lose his money. He doesn't give anything free, whether Jio or Maro. He wants to earn profit, isn't it? Nothing comes in this world free, or no one wants to do a social service to the society. Only one thing is there, how shall I earn profit? And no one has to teach this to anyone in this world, how to earn profit. So Tukaram Maharaj says that, are, is there any need to teach anyone how to earn profit? Tala kaya far shikavave. Do we really need to learn how to earn profit? It's not needed. And that is the business. But Next line, what he says, what is that business after all? Do you come here? We come in the association of the devotees, not to seek contacts, not to seek, how shall I earn? How shall I earn in dollars? I'll get some tricks how to earn. No, that is not the business of a devotee when they come together. So what is the business of a devotee? Hita te karave devache chintana. Karuniya mana ekavida. What is that profit? What is that business? Hita te karave devache chintana. We come here not to form a political party, isn't it? Jana Sangha. Actually, Prabhupada writes this in a shloka of Jana Sangascha Lolamcha Shadbir Bhakti Prasiddhati. The six items which helps a devotee to progress in Krishna consciousness. So one of the item is Jana Sangha. Coming in the association of the devotees. So when we come in the association, we are not forming some political party. Jana Sangha, earlier it was a political party. So one might think, are these people are of this party or what? No. Jana Sangha here refers to the business. Devache Chintana. Chintan is what? About Deva, Krishna. Discussion about Lord. Karuniya mana ekavidha. Not with a distracted mind. I am sitting here and thinking when the class get over. Huh? Many people complained. One person asked me, why do you keep prasadam after the class? Isn't it? Well, at least people with that interest will sit in the class. Otherwise, people will have no one ahead. Isn't it? And now, of course, you all are interested in Krishna Katha. Karuniya mana ekavidha. That is where we have to do investment. That is the real business of a devotee. To earn the profit. By discussing Krishna Katha, by talking about Krishna. Most of the time when we come together, we talk about the devotees. Are this devotee has done that, that devotee has done that. But we never talk with the devotees. How is your Krishna consciousness going on? What struggle you are facing? What are you reading? Tell me about Krishna Katha. Tell me about these devotees, their glories. So when we come together, we should come together to discuss and glorify about Lord. That is the only business. That is the investment. Otherwise, if we do other investment, as Kulshikar Maharaj, he speaks, other than investment in a Krishna consciousness or in the spirit, all our investment is subjected to risk. Idam shariram parinam peshalam patatya vasham shatasandhi jarjaram. Most of the time, our investment goes into the taking care of our body. What shall I eat? How am I looking? Which dress need to be wear? All the time, we are investing our energy, we are investing our time in thinking about body. But what is this body all about? Patatya vasham. It is certainly going to fall. Is there any doubt? There is no doubt at all. Even if somebody has that doubt, it will get removed. Yeah? Soon. So patatyavasyam satasandhi jarjaram. So our business, our investment is only this. Hita te karave deva che chintana. Remembering Lord, discussing about Him. And that is what a spiritual life is. Spiritual life is nothing but reviving our relationship with Krishna. That is our business. That beautiful relationship, that beautiful risk we have to take of reviving our relationship with Krishna. So here today we are going to discuss about Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. Now in Mumbai everyone is talking about who will become Mahapur. Isn't it? But what is our business? To discuss about Mahaprabhu. Isn't it? That is the real business. And we come in the line of Gaudiya Vaishnava Sampradaya. Madhva Gaudiya Vaishnava Sampradaya. This is the line in which Chaitanya Mahaprabhu accepted initiation. And the mood of this lineage, this parampara, is what? Gopir Bhartur Padakamalayor Das Dasanu Das. This is the mood of Gaudiya Vaishnava Parampara. And to teach this mood, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu appeared. Yadi Gaur na hoito, tabe ki hoito, kemo ne dhari tande. This is the mood. Nobody wants to be controller, but Das Dasanu Das. We are struggling with our names, you know, Das, this and this Das, this and this Dasi, isn't it? So what to speak of Das Dasanu Das? Earlier, somebody always asked, hey, what was your previous name? What was your previous name? Many people have that curiosity whenever we say our spiritual name. So generally I say, see, I was non-devotee before and also non-devotional name. Now, I am still non-devotee, but the spiritual name. Isn't it? Just getting a spiritual name, the mood has not developed. So we are struggling just to become a Das. What to speak of Das Dasanu Das? Das Dasanu Das, Das Dasanu Das. So one devotee, he left his body long back in 2005-2006. When initiation was going on, so this devotee came up and we are supposed to take vow and we also need to express our mood of Gaudiya Parampara. So this devotee came and pronounced his vow. I will follow four regulative principles. I will serve in the mission of Prabhupada. In the mood of, he spoke, Das, Dasanu Das, Dasanu Das, Dasanu Das, Dasanu Das, Dasanu Das, Dasanu Das, he went on. So the spiritual master, seeing this mood of this person, instantly gave him a name. Your name will be Das, Dasanu Das. So, we have our struggle with just becoming a Das. And this mood is very, very difficult to adopt and apply in life. Once in Vrindavan, Lord Krishna, as a Gopa Balak, he grew up to 5. No, it was more than five. He was, and all the elders of cowherd community, they came together and they were discussing. Now Krishna has grown up. And similarly, when we come in the Krishna consciousness, our elders also develop. Now this person has become stable. So there is a need to give him some responsibility. Some seva will come, isn't it? So now here Krishna has grown up to five. And everyone, elders, they were discussing. Now Krishna should be given charge of cows. And they told Krishna, Krishna, now you are going to take charge of cows. Krishna, what did he say? Was he ready? No. As like we are not ready to do any service. First, our response is no. Then somebody will say, no, you have to do it. So the Krishna also said that, no, I won't. And he gave a reason why I can't. He said, cows are so big, I am so small. How can I control cows, such a big, big cows? So everyone thought, yeah, he is giving a right reason. He is so small, cows are so big. So they again came together and they again discussed. What did they discuss? They said, still we'll give him a charge. We'll give him this charge to take care of cows. Why? Because all these cows and the calves, they love Krishna so much, they shower their love on him so much that they will get control themselves. There is no need of Krishna to control them. They will take care of Krishna. So that is the mood of Vrindavan. Not to control, but to be controlled. The love permeates so much that a devotee or the Lord, even Lord is saying, no, I don't want to control, I don't want to take care. But everyone is ready to get controlled by the devotees or the Lord. That is the mood of Vrindavan Dham. And what is our mood? As soon as we look forward for a position so that I can control better. The mood of Vrindavan is what? How shall I serve better? Not that how shall I control better. That is the mood. That is what? Das, dasanu das. Let us be controlled by others or devotees or the Lord. But in Kali Yuga, with so many complexities, so much of darkness, it's very difficult. It's very difficult. So much of perversion of consciousness, hypocrisy, all these things are pervading everywhere. How can we save ourselves? How can we develop such mood? Das, dasanu das. And which is the tallest order after all. With so much of arrogance, so much of ego in Kali Yuga, it is very difficult to develop this mood. The mentality of Kali Yuga is very, very difficult to fathom. Once our Gaur Krishna Maharaj had come here in Chowpatty and he had taken one Sunday feast class like this. So he spoke very nice story about His Holiness Radha Govind Maharaj. Radha Govind Maharaj, he went to his town, one of the town, and he was passing his day performing services and doing prachar. So he saw one very old person, elderly gentleman. He would always go out in a close by farms, sit at a place and would look towards highway. One highway was passing by from that village or that town, and he would always see the vehicles moving. So Radha Govind Maharaj observed this phenomena with this person, and once he met him and told this person, this, now you are becoming old. Shatasandhi jarjaram, idam shariram parinam peshalam. You know, you are becoming old. Instead of just wasting your time looking at vehicles moving, why don't you chant, take holy name, hear Krishna katha? And after all, what do you see? Vehicles moving. So the reply what he gave, that startled Maharaj much more than what he spoke to him. The reply, what reply he gave, you know? They were conversing in Hindi. तो उसने कहा कि एक वहां पर एक ब्रिज था, ब्रिज फ्रॉम वेयर द व्हीकल्स वेर क्रॉसिंग. सो वाटर वॉज गोइंग बिलो एंड द व्हीकल्स वेर क्रॉसिंग. तो ही सेड दैट, दैट मैन सेड, अगर ये ब्रिज टूट जाए और एक गाड़ियां इतने स्पीड में चल रही है तो गिरने के बाद कितना मजा आएगा ना. This is a perverse mentality of Kaliyuga. The vehicles are moving and that bridge get collapsed. So when the vehicles are falling in it, how interesting it would be to see. Kitna maja aayega na. So Maharaj is also Maharaj, you know. So what Maharaj replied? He replied him that, what if if you come to know your son and daughter is there in the vehicle. So that is the Kaliyuga. The perverse mentality what we have cannot be fathomed. And cheating propensity, my God, not to talk about that. One person met his friend after a long time, that also in a town. And most of the time, in a town and villages, you always get electricity, means it is always fluctuating. The power failure. Sometimes to provide it to the cities, they generally shut off the electricity in the towns. So, what this person was complaining him, this friend who came to town, the person who was staying in the town, he was complaining, "Arey yaar, what is this? This electricity people, they are useless guys. They don't do anything. So many times, the power is going off. We can't do anything." So the friend told him, "Arey, go and complain to your electricity officer, whoever in charge is there." So again he said, "What is this useless people?" So again the friend told, "Go and complain. What I will do? I can do nothing for you. I can just hear your complaint." After third time he again spoke. And after speaking this, he showed him something strange. He took him, the friend who had come from city, he took him out and showed him towards wire, electricity wires which was passing through his home. So what he had done, he had put a akada, it is generally said, and taken electricity from there without any meter. So he showed him, see, and you are telling me, go and complain to officer. If I complain to officer, he will first ask me, where is your bill? So even to complain, a person need to be proper receiver. The cheating propensity is so much. In Kali Yuga, nobody wants to perform sacrifice, but everyone wants to, everyone is interested and wants to get rewards. Are barish thik nahi hota hai, dhoop itni gir jati hai, itna mehengai bad gaya hai, isn't it? So nobody is interested in performing sacrifice. Sacrifice is yagya. Yajnanat yajnat karmanan netra, isn't it? So this is a cheating mentality. And arrogance, my God, it is the top of the everyone, even a small dhakka, it can give you a good burn. One day a boy was eating a chocolate, and neighboring kaka, chacha, saw him eating chocolate. And as a good advice to be given, isn't it? It is a dharma of a So this kaka came and told this a child, "Bala beta, don't eat too many chocolates, you know. What happens? Chocolates, they decay your teeth. You will spoil your teeth. So don't eat chocolate." So the boy heard and replied, "Bala, kaka, kaka, do you know? My grandfather, he lived for 120 years. So the kaka became amazed. "Bala, yeah, so by eating chocolate, he became, he lived so long?" So the child replied, "No, no, kaka, he never poke his nose in others' business. You mind your own business." So this is the height of arrogance, you know, in Kali Yuga. You cannot even advise good thing to anyone. Everyone thinks, "I know better than you, what you will going to tell me." So Kali Yuga, there is no hope at all. With such arrogance, such hypocrisy, such cheating mentality, such perverse mentality. And then what we are doing, coming in the association, we are trying to follow four regulative principles. No meat eating, no illicit sex, no gambling, no intoxication. Once a friend of Shikshashtakam Prabhu, he told him, "Ki are tu jeeta kyun hai?" Means he said, "Are, we follow these four regulative principles, no meat eating, no gambling, no illicit sex, no intoxication." So the friend instantly replied, "Agar if these things are not there, so how do you enjoy? It's better to die. Tu jeeta kyun hai yaar?" And one relative, or one elderly person, one of our senior devotee, Shyamanand Prabhu, when he had joined, and he told that elderly person that, "We are following these four regulatory principles, I am practicing Krishna consciousness." So what was his instant reply? He said, "Are, this is the age where you should sin." Means this is the age of 19, 20, 30s, where you are supposed to be sinning. Paap kar tu. And you are chanting holy name, you are following four regulative principles. So what is the meant, what is the environment we are living in? Where is the encouragement? Our media is bombarding, do this thing. Our people around us, our each books we study, our education is bombarding. Eat, meet, sleep. These are the things are propagated. Where is the question to maintain our determination to follow these four regulative principles? That is only possible when, and in one of the ages, in one of the yugas, there was Ajamil. Ajamil, his habits were pakka. His culture were pakka. He never smoked. Prabhupada said he never went to cinemas. What was the culture? Refined personality, along with qualities, along with his culture, behavior, the atmosphere around them. None of you, his relative, were telling like, "Arey, kya kar raha hai tu?" Isn't it? Still, he fall victim. He fell victim to the onslaught of material energy. When he saw a low class person embracing a low class woman. So what is the hope for all of us? To survive and follow these practices of Krishna consciousness. And we are able to give up all such habits we all had. Of course, many of you might not have been, but many of us have gone through experiencing this onslaught of material energy. But how come we are able to follow now? What is that mystery? So Krishnaraj Kaviraj Goswami explains that Sri Krishna Chaitanya Nityananda Sahodito Gauradeyo Pushpavanto Chitro Shando Tamovandho. It is only because of Lord Chaitanya and Lord Nityananda we are able to follow these rules and regulation and practices of Krishna consciousness. Sri Krishna Chaitanya Nityananda Sahodito. The moon and the sun has arisen on the horizon of Gaura Desh. Lord Gauranga and Lord Nityananda has appeared to illuminate the darkness caused by the age of Kali Yuga, to give hope and strength to the upholder of dharma and one who is aspiring to revive their relationship with Krishna. Gauradeyo pushpavanto chitro shando tamovandho. The darkness is prevailing everywhere. Prabhupada, in one of the purport, he writes interesting thing that he talks about the eyes of Lord Krishna or eyes of Lord God. Of course, they are beautiful, isn't it? The Lord's eyes are beautiful. But they perform another function in the material world. What is that? Are you interested to know? Yes. Thank you. So, He says that the eyes of the Lord can see present what you are doing. Isn't it? Not only present, but what you have done in the past. What you were. Isn't it? Everyone is afraid of past. Sometimes it is said, every saint has a past and every sinner has a future. That is the hope. So, Prabhupada says, he says present, not only present, but the past. And also future. It is called PPF. Isn't it? They generally have a provident fund. Isn't it? So Krishna not only sees present, but also sees past. And his eyes also sees future. What you would be. Okay, not only that. Not only in India, you might say, oh, Krishna appeared in India. Isn't it? So that wouldn't be applicable to India, because Krishna is looking after Indians only. Isn't it? But no. What Prabhupada says? Krishna's eyes not only see present, but past, but future, but also everywhere. Whether it is India, whether it is Asia, whether it is Europe, or whether it is Antarctica. Even in the smallest of the jiva, in the icy cold of Antarctica, is been watched by Lord Krishna's eyes. Everywhere, not only this 7-continent world, isn't it? But Prabhupada goes next. He says that every corner of the universe, Krishna's eyes are seeing. Even if you might say, my business, Krishna will look at me as long as I am on this earth. Isn't it? Once I reach heaven, swarga, then maja hi maja, bas. Hai na? Most of the time we take up religion with the aspiration that there will be some enjoyment in heaven. Swarga mein maja karna. And that is the also promises given by many. But Krishna's eyes even following you in the universe, every corner of the universe, whether it is Narak or whether it is Swarak. And interestingly, Prabhupada doesn't stop there, or Krishna's eyes doesn't stop there. His vision doesn't stop there. Not only past, present, future, not only his eyes are seeing everywhere, not even in the corner of the universe, but Prabhupada says, every corner of the heart of every living entity. So Krishna is watching what is going on in this living entity's heart. What is thinking now? Is he thinking to invest in spiritual life? Or is he thinking to invest in material life? Is he thinking to invest in spirit or in matter? Which business he wants to do. That Krishna's eyes are watching. It's scary. That what I'm thinking now is being watched by Lord. As I was talking about the darkness of Kali Yuga, that is also prevailing. See, external darkness can be mitigated by the sun and the moon of this world. But the darkness which is prevailing in the heart of a living entity, from time immemorial, it is very, very difficult to drive that away. Krishna has a power to take away everything from us. That is the power of Krishna. That is the power of God. But only one thing He cannot take away is our desire to enjoy material world. And that is considered the greatest darkness. So that is what Krishna is going to as the Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu and Nityananda Prabhu is driving away the darkness which is prevailing in the people living in Kali Yuga. Chitro Shando Tamovando. So then Krishna Ras Kaviraj Goswami, he goes ahead. This is the beginning of Sri Chaitanya Charitamrita. And then he goes on explaining about Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. And that is the topic of discussion. Then he says that, who is this Chaitanya Mahaprabhu? It's a beautiful verse from Adi Leela. Yadadvaitam brahmopanishadi tad api asya tanubha yad atmantarayami purusha iti so swayam swamsha vibhava shadaishwarya purno yaha bhagavan sa swayamayam na chaitanyat krishna jagati paratattvam param iha. That what Upanishadas and Vedas call as Brahman, Brahmopanishadi, as we all know that Prabhupada has told us and Bhagavatam also explains that God can be realized in three features. What are they? The Brahman realization, the all-pervading aspect of Lord. That is Brahman realization. And the next level of God realization is Paramatma realization. As Lord sitting in everyone's heart, guiding living entity as per His desire. Ubdrashta Anumanta Bharta Bhokta Ayoj. As a Paramatma is sitting in living entity's heart. And the highest realization of Godhead is personal form of Lord Krishna. So Upanishadas and all other Vedic scripture, they talk about Brahman, the all-pervading aspect of Lord Krishna. Even if we connect to this realization, even if somebody reaches to Brahman platform, it gives happiness. It is called Brahmanand. And next to that is Krishna as a Paramatma. So all the yogis, all the nannies, they are trying to connect to Paramatma. And there is also a greater happiness. And highest is definitely the personal form of Krishna. What to speak of that then? The highest, if it is the personal form of Krishna, is the highest. Then if we connect, the experience is unlimited. Actually, it is very difficult. We can hear and say that Krishna is everywhere. It is very simple to say about that. But the most difficult part is that, are we conscious? Are we conscious about Krishna's presence everywhere? It's really very difficult. Even if we hear continuously, some or other, a living entity has this tendency to forget the Krishna's presence everywhere. So what to speak of connecting with the Paramatma? And then what to speak of connecting with the personal form of Lord? But Chaitanya Mahaprabhu is helping living entity to get connected to this personal form of the Lord and develop our relationship. In Brahman, there is a happiness, but there is no service. There is no reciprocation. There is no relationship. And in Paramatma realization also, there is a relationship, but no service. But when personal form is realized, then there is a relationship and there is a service. And service gives the most blissful experience to anyone and everyone. We enjoy service when we enjoy serving someone. And that gives us happiness. Of course, what we don't enjoy is working. Working is different than service. Service is voluntary. Service is an expression of love. You perform services for reciprocation. It is for experience. And that happiness, that ananda, that paramananda, access to that paramananda is given. This Shad Aishwarya Purna, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu's explanation is given. He is also, Krishna is full of six opulences. And that is the state of a Bhagavan. Bhagavan means six opulences. So Chaitanya Mahaprabhu is also described, Shad Aishwarya Purno Bhagavan Swayam. He is also full of six opulences. But what is the problem in relationship? There are twofold problem. We don't want to become servant. That relationship with Krishna or the God of a living entity is of a master and the servant. And our experience in this world with master is a bit difficult. So why we are afraid or people are scared to develop relationship with Krishna? First, he demands purification. And to tell you the fact, we are afraid of purification. Secretly, we enjoy our anarthas, impurity, somehow or other. Therefore, Krishna says, clear your piety, clear your sins. Then only you come to me. And he goes one step ahead. Okay, no problem. Even if you don't want to clear your papa, you don't want to clear your this tendency, you come to me, I will take care. But he wants purification. That is for sure. You cannot escape Krishna without getting purified. If Krishna is there in your life, you should take it granted that purification is must. So this is the one reason that we don't want to develop relationship, or people are scared to develop relationship. And second, that no faith in intention. If you doubt someone's intention, then there will not be any relationship. Relationship means having faith, having trust in the intention of the person you are developing relationship with. If you doubt intention of a person, and so we don't know what is Krishna's intention, so we don't have that faith, we don't have a trust. So therefore, we are scared to develop relationship with Krishna. We are afraid not to go close, that he may utilize, he may exploit us. Any master we have seen in this world, and once Radhesham Prabhu was telling this, what is the mentality of a servant or worker in this world? He wants to do job for minimum hours, lesser and lesser hours, and get full salary. Isn't it? He want to work less, but want full salary. And what is the mentality of a master? He want to make him work 24 hours and give nothing. He doesn't want to pay. That is the servant and master relationship in this world. A master doesn't want to pay and servant doesn't want to work. A servant want full reward and master just want to exploit. So therefore we have experienced this in this world, so we are very much afraid of developing relationship with Krishna. That how, what if I start serving Krishna, if I don't get love of Godhead, what will happen? My material enjoyment has also gone. And this also has not been achieved. People have asked Prabhupada, what if you realize Krishna is not there when you die? So Prabhupada also replied befittingly. Prabhupada said, even if we come to know that Krishna is not there at the end of our life, still we had a good life. We danced, we ate prasad, we came together and we enjoyed life healthily, isn't it? But what if you come to know that Krishna is there, and you have wasted your life just enjoying the matter, there will be a big problem. And I'm sure Krishna is there. Isn't it? So, this is what, you know, we are afraid of. Why we don't want to take to Krishna consciousness or develop relationship, which offers most wonderful experience. We have been cheated in this world with the people. Therefore, we don't want to trust anyone. Isn't it? So therefore, people first, that is what, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu has come to give us. that you need not have to be afraid. What he was giving first, he is giving not Krishna. This misconception we have to remove, that Chaitanya Mahaprabhu is giving Krishna. What Rupa Goswami said? He is not giving Krishna. What he is giving? Krishna prema pradayate. He is giving Krishna prem, love of Godhead. Unless you, first what he is giving container. See, if I say, I have a milk, 5-liter milk, and take it, without any bag, huh? But first question you will ask, let me bring container to hold it. If you don't have a container, even if I give you 100 liters of milk or ghee, patmeda, isn't it? If you don't have a container, you will not be able to hold it. Similarly, when we have been given Krishna, when if we are given God, but if we don't have a container to hold it, even if Krishna comes in our life, we will not be able to appreciate. We will not be able to take it. So that is the glory of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, that he came to offer us Krishna Prem. Krishna came in the life of Dhritarashtra, Krishna came in the life of Duryodhana. But they could not develop relationship with Krishna. Why? Because they did not have that love for him. So, seeing the condition of the material, in the Kali Yuga, in material world, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu is offering this Krishna Prema Pradayate. Therefore, he is called Mahavadanyaya. Then he says, Krishna Das Kaviraj Goswami says, that what gift he has given Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. Anarpita charim chirat karunaya varti nakkalo samarpaito ujvalo rasam sabhakti shriyam Haripurada sundara diti kadamba sandipir sadaridaya kandare spuratuva sachinandana. Anarpita charim, anarpita chiram. It has been never offered before. No incarnation has offered this Krishna prem. Anarpita. But what is doing? Samarpita. From which is not offered in any ages, by any incarnation. He came to samarpit. Anarpita charim chirat karunaya avatirna kalo. Taking compassion in his heart in this age of Kali Yuga, he is offering this Krishna prem. Samarpita unnato ujvalo rasam so bhakti shriyam hari purada sundara dviti kadamba sandipit sadar dhaya kandare svurutu vasuji. So no religion in this world has taught its follower the rasa theology. The rasa theology means that exchanging, as we have developed relationship with God, so there are exchanges of rasa. There is exchanges of rasa. There is experience. No religion in this world has taught its follower about the mellows of Supreme Personality of Godhead. and that is given in the first few days of Krishna consciousness. What are that? What these rasas are? Shantaras, then Dasyaras. How a devotee develops relationship with Krishna? On reverence, as being a servant. Then there is a Sakyaras, as a friendship. Then there is a Vatsalya, as his parent. And topmost is Madhurya. Rasa was unheard, unspoken, even unthought. Recently, one of our devotees, Ayutthaya Prabhu, gave a nice Bhagavatam class, and he was talking about Ravindra Swarup Prabhu. Ravindra Swarup Prabhu is one of the senior disciples and was GBC. He took retirement from his services currently and is preaching. So, is one of the senior devotee in ISKCON. So he was born and brought up in Western country, and his parents would always move from different places, and his parents had taken care that he should go to the Sunday class. The Sunday, here we have a Sunday fun school. So similarly, in many religions, they utilize Sundays to give knowledge about God. So, in one of the Sunday school, Ravindra Swarup Prabhu used to go. And the God, the information about God, what he had was, God is the greatest. He can get things done as just a fingertip. As you just have to think and everything will be done. So this is the picture he had in his childhood, what God means. So as he was learning this, so he had one question, and he would always ask to the teachers that if God can get things done just in a chutki bajake, generally we say, on his fingertips, so then what did Lord do with the time? Agar sab kaam agar ho ja raha hai, so what is Lord doing with his time? Isn't it? If you are not engaged in any activity, generally they say, how are you killing your time? So he had basically that question. How does Lord kill his time? Isn't it? And this question bewildered many people. First of all, they would say this is unallowed question. Means it is not allowed here. Not to ask. And then he grew up just thinking that, some mystery would be there. Ki what does God do with this time? And we are being told, ki no, go to the paradise, go to the paradise, go to the heaven, go to the heaven. This is not the real place. Material world is a place of miseries and all these things. So what makes paradise attractive? Why shall I go? If I go there and I get bored just sitting and looking at God, and he is looking at me, is that the only thing I'm supposed to be doing there? And he developed the concept or thought that God must be getting bored in his abode, isn't it? Because he has so much time and he has nothing to do. So this picture of God, that having such a reciprocation, the relationship with the God, is never been presented in any of the theology or any of the religion. As he was talking. But here in in Krishna consciousness, we learn such rasas or relationship with the Lord as soon as we spend some time in Krishna consciousness. As we understand, we are not the soul, we are we are not the body, we are soul. And soul has a relationship with Krishna. So this is very, very powerful concept. This is the first thing which is not available. That the rasa theory, the rasa theology is offered by Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. Anarpita chinam. The second thing, the kinds of the prayers we do here is hardly somewhere you will find the kind of prayers we chant. Before coming to Krishna consciousness, I have always heard and always done the prayer, Dhanam Dehi, Janam Dehi, isn't it? I used to perform some abhishek to some deities. So the pujari would make sure that I should recite this verse or this prayer. Yava Dhanam Dehi, Janam Dehi. But when we come to Krishna consciousness, the prayers what we have been taught and the mood we need to develop is what? Na Dhanam, Na Janam, Na Sundarim, Kavitam Va Jagadish Kamae, Mama Janmani Janmani Shware, Bhavatad Bhakti Rahe Tuki Toi. Na Dhanam. Pahila hi sunke sochega, restricted. Isn't it? Isn't it? You come here and pray like this. Na Dhanam. Na Janam. No followers. We want to be on the Facebook so that we can feel good that I have so many followers. Isn't it? But here what Chaitanya Mahaprabhu is saying, Na Dhanam, Na Janam, Na Sundarim, or Sundar, whatever, for for everyone it is applied. You might say it is only for male or what. They are not even aspiring for a Sundari or a Sundar personality. Na Dhanam, Na Janam, Na Sundarim, and Kavitam Va. The fame. Everyone wants to get famous by hook or crook. By speaking good or by speaking lie. If you can become famous, then that is the success. But these are the things which have been taught, the kinds of prayers we have been taught in Krishna consciousness. Our niece of Subhash Chandra Bose, she came in touch with devotees, and she saw the lifestyle of a devotees and how they are happy in practicing Krishna consciousness. So she had a guru. She went to her guru and told him that you are giving so much to your follower. Whatever they ask, whatever problem they have, you resolve their problems. You are such a guru. But still your followers are miserable. He was a great yogi. And he could fulfill the desires of his followers. Well, you are giving so much. But just see the disciples of A.C. Bhaktivedanta Swami Prabhupada. That what he is saying to his people. Give up all these things. Na Dhanam, Na Janam, Na Sundarim. Don't aspire. Don't ask anything from the Lord. And still they are happy. They are dancing. They are doing so much. What is this mystery? They are much more happier than what your followers are. So a devotee becomes much more happier by praying like this. And that is what Maitreya Muni, he told Vidurji that what is the mood of a devotee? Nave Mukundasya Padaravindayo Rajo Jushastad Babadrisha Jana Vanchanti Tadasya Ritertam Atmana Yadrichaya Labdamana Samriddhaya. That a devotee of the Lord does not desire anything else than the service of the Lord. Nave Mukundasya Padaravindayo Rajo Jushas Tat, he is calling Vidurji is my dear son Tat. It's a very affectionate word. Rajo Jushas, they are aspiring for what? The dust of the lotus feet of the Lord. That is their aspiration. People like you, means he is telling to Vidurji, they don't go for Dhanam, Janam and Sundarim and Kavitam in this world. They go after what? Rajo Jusham, the dust of lotus feet of the Lord. And therefore, they don't want anything. Vanchanti tad dasyam. So, they don't want anything, but they want what? Vanchanti tad dasyam. I want to be servant of your lotus feet. I want to be servant of your servant. Why they want that? Because yadrichaya labdha mana samruddhaya. When your mind, when your heart is satisfied, will you desire anything else in this world? So devotee of the Lord is that person whose mind is labdha samruddhaya. He is a samruddha. He has fulfilled all his desires. And therefore, what he is desiring? Vanchanti tadadasyam. I want to become your servant. And that is the mood he has been given by Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. That is the prayers we all are doing. So this is the second. Anarpita. He's never been in, not taught in any other religion. God, give me my bread and butter. Prabhupada would say, are God anyway going to give? He is giving to the animals and the all other living entities. And the third thing, which is also very out of the world in Krishna consciousness, is the view what we have about the world. The way we look at the world. This has been taught by Prabhupada. Prabhupada was giving a class in, it is a hub of sense gratification of the world. You know, we all have one dream as Indians. Now it is getting startled, you know, that a dream America, isn't it? I preach to many college students. So whenever I ask them, what is your desire? What what is your future plan? So they generally talk that I want to fly abroad. And mostly America, isn't it? Because that is the land, and they say it's promising for sense gratification, not any other thing. Isn't it? Promise sense gratification. And we aim, and earlier people would consider if their, what is success of life, if they could go to north. Hena? North means is a disha where self-realization can be achieved. Himalayas are there, so that people would consider that is the success of life. So today what people consider success of life? If you go to west, that is the success of life. From north we have shifted to west. That is our advancement. So Prabhupada was in America, in the center of the universe, where for sense gratification. And what Prabhupada is calling is interesting. He was giving class and he was telling, we are here in this remote corner of the world. Means what he is saying, or what he was seeing, the Detroit is a remote corner of world. And Mayapur is the center of the universe. We have never heard about Mayapur before coming to Krishna consciousness. We have heard only one, Mayapuri. Isn't it? Not Mayapur. And what Prabhupada is calling, that is the center of the universe. That worldview means what is seen as a gold, Prabhupada is seeing it as a, or the view is given to us as a iron. And what we see as a gold is nothing but the iron. Such kind of worldview is rarely to be found. Anarpita chirim. It's not been given. Anarpit. That is what Chaitanya Mahaprabhu has given to all of us. When Lord Vishnu appeared to in front of Dhruva Maharaj. So, Lord said to Dhruva Maharaj that this is very difficult task you have accomplished. Sudurjayam, Sudurlabham. To have audience with the Lord and to experience love of Godhead. It's very difficult. Very, very difficult. It is said, Suduragama. Duragama means very difficult. And Suduragana means superlative. That task. And therefore, it became a news for the whole universe. That the son of Uttanapada, which was, who is a 5 year old child, he achieved Krishna, or he could conquer this most difficult part, or this most difficult success to be achieved. We think earning is most difficult, or maintaining our bank balance is most difficult, or develop, or maintaining relationship is the difficult. That is, that will come and go. But what Sudurlabham, Suduragama is experiencing the relationship, the happiness of Lord Krishna. And that became the news. But what Chaitanya Mahaprabhu is doing in Kali Yuga? From smallest of the child in Krishna consciousness to the oldest of the person, everyone has given a chance to experience that the same thing which was very difficult to obtain. Prabhupada had to say that Krishna consciousness is so simple. What we have to do? Come in the association, chant, dance, eat prasadam, and do not criticize devotees. That thing, if we take care, we will go back home, back to Godhead. So simple. Sometimes people might lose this because they may think, "Arey, it is so simple. Just chant and be happy." That is what Krishna is giving to all of us. That's what Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu is giving to all of us. In that form. So, let us cherish, let us absorb ourselves in upcoming Gaur Purnima festival. As I was telling all of you, that instead of discussing who will be the Mahapur, let us discuss about Mahaprabhu for this week, isn't it? And be ready to receive these blessings and the mercy of Lord Chaitanya in our life. Be ready. In one of the purport, Prabhupada writes, how to take up this Krishna consciousness. He says that to get Chaitanya Mahaprabhu's mercy, what we have to do? We have to engage ourselves like we were engaged for getting sense gratification. How we engaged ourselves enjoy our senses. Similarly, to receive the mercy of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, we have to engage. And to receive mercy, what we have to do? We have to beg, Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Ram, Hare Ram, Ram Ram, Hare Hare, Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu ki, Nitai Gaur Premanande. So, let us become a beggar. And just Bhakti Tirtha Swami has written, we are beggars of mercy. Let us beg to Chaitanya Mahaprabhu to drive away that darkness in our heart. Let us develop that compassion for the devotees. These are the words, I am also the instrument of the great acharyas like Prabhupada and his followers. So let us develop that mood and experience this gift of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, this mercy of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu in our lives. That should be the resolve of all of us. That should be our investment. That should be our business. And then we will see that Sudurjayam path has been conquered by each and everyone who sincerely follows the process of Krishna consciousness, and one who receives the gifts of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu with grateful heart. Hare Krishna. So I'll stop here. Now it's already been 3 o'clock. So instead of question answer, we'll have a kirtan, and after that you all can take lunch prasadam. Hare Krishna.